respected chair, all the distinguished scholars who are going to make presentations at this session, venerable sirs, venerable nuns, Hindu clergy, ladies and gentlemen. First of all, I would like to pay my thanks to India Foundation for two reasons. The first reason is it is India Foundation that has been given me a chance to come to Delhi University in 1990 for doing my PhD. India Foundation provided me a scholarship to pursue my PhD degree. Therefore, I am very much thankful for India Foundation. Secondly, I pay my sincere thanks to India Foundation as well as Nalanda University for inviting me to come here as a speaker of this conference. And also, I am very glad to convince you from the beginning of Dharma-Dhamma conference in Nalanda University, our distinguished young scholars participated in this conference, and I am very happy to say this time nearly 12 young academics are participating at this conference. It is something very important. And this conference is on, the main theme of the conference is Sat-Chit-Ananda and Nirvana. Sat-Chit-Ananda stand for Hinduism, whereas Nirvana stand for Buddhism. This type of conference or dialogue is not new to India. It has long historic, this type of dialogue is long historic relationship. Even at the time of Buddha himself visited other religious leaders, and other religious leaders are often visited Buddha and make debates and discussions about the subtle points in Buddhism and also other religious tradition. Sometimes our canonical literature reveals that many dialogues between Buddha and other religious leaders, sometimes had very serious dialogues. Those dialogues were aimed at convincing the truth, not for disgrace any other tradition, but in order to make better understanding about the reality. Therefore, this type of dialogue is very essential at the moment, especially because we are having a lot of problems in the world due to various type of religious beliefs. The main reason for having such conflict is misunderstanding or unawareness of the other religion. Therefore, it is very important to have a knowledge of one's own religion as well as religion of others. It is need of at the present to make consider the higher in the level of higher education to produce scholars, those who are having wide knowledge on one's own religion as well as the religion of others. And therefore, the steps taken by Nalanda University is very much appreciative. As I mentioned earlier, the main theme of this conference is Sat-Chit-Ananda, or in other words, Hinduism and Buddhism. Chronologically concerned, Hinduism is the most ancient religious tradition in India. Its origins goes as far back as to Vedic period. Hindu tradition historically can be divided into three categories. The one is the period of Bhakti Marga, which represent Vedic religion. At the time of this Bhakti Marga period, many gods were believed, sacrifices, many prayers were uttered to keep the gods satisfied. The second period is the Karma Marga. It is the period of Brahmanic period. Many type of sacrifices existed during the period. The last period is the period of Jnana Marga, which represent Upanishadic literature. It is during the Upanishadic period, pay attention to realize what is the ultimate reality of being and the world. Upanishadic philosophers identified two realities. One is the reality of individual, which is called Atman, and the reality of Brahman. The later development of Atman, Brahman, Atman and Brahma was identified together, and they considered it as the one reality. It is called Tat Tvam Asi, and that is the peak of development of reality according to Vedantic tradition. According to Upanishadic teaching, Hindu philosophy, the external world or the visible world is Maya. So out of Maya or illusion, we have to recognize the reality. And according to the visible world is not reality, the reality is what is behind. So they wanted to identify the reality in reality out of the visible world. The reality that they found is the Atman and Brahman. And according to Buddhist perspective, reality is the reality is the visible reality. What we can perceive through our senses itself is the reality. There is no reality behind. That is the difference between Hinduism and Buddhism. Buddhism confess there is no other reality behind this empirical world. Empirical world itself is the reality. That is the distinctive feature of Buddhism. So this reality has been expounded by the Buddha in his first discourse, Dhamma Chakka Pavaptana Sutta. Dhamma has been used in different context, in different meaning. Here in Dhamma Chakka Pavaptana Sutta, Dhamma is identified as the reality. It is synonymous as reality. Dhamma is synonymous for reality. And what is Dhamma Chakka Pavaptana Sutta expounded is the Four Noble Truth. That is the suffering, the cause of suffering, and cessation of suffering, and way to cessation of suffering. So this is the reality, very simple. There is something empirical and it is very understandable. So we need not to think about, there is nothing behind. So what Buddha expounded is the Four Noble Truth is the reality. There is no other reality. Buddha himself says, if anybody expound the other reality than Four Noble Truth, that is wrong, that is impossible. So reality can be identified within this Four Noble Truth. So in explaining the first noble truth, it can be very easily identified. It is very empirical. And also in expounding the Four Noble Truth, there is one very deep, very there is one term in Dhammacakkappavattana Sutta. Buddha says, appativattyam devenava marenava brahmunava appativattyam. The truth that I have been expounded cannot be changed by God or any other supernatural being. It is the reality. Then in expounding the reality, he says, what is suffering? Jatipi dukkha, jarapi dukkha, maranampi dukkha, vyadipi dukkha, and various type of sufferings that we are undergoing. That is the reality. So in order to extinguish this reality, what is the cause of reality? It is tanha, the craving, desire. Yayam tanha pono bhavika tatra tatra abhinandini. That is how it is elaborated in Dhammacakkappavattana Sutta. Tanha is the reason for having this type of suffering. Then the cessation of suffering, it is the distinguishing of the craving. If no craving, there is no suffering. So the way to get rid of suffering is the Noble Eightfold Path. That is how Buddha expounded the reality. So today's theme is the Ananda. Ananda is the happiness. That is what we all expect for. So if we get something what we desire, that is where the Ananda or happiness is. The one who go through the Noble Eightfold Path, the final result would be the happiness or Nibbana, ultimate reality. I have no time. Thank you very much.